हेलो, नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब, कसर काय, केड़ो हाल आए, केन छो। आई एम आभा जाधव, वंस अगेन वेलकमिंग यू ऑल टू योर फेवरेट टॉक शो स्पॉटलाइट विद आभा इन कोलैबोरेशन विद रेडियो वेनराइट। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी हैव एन इंस्पायरिंग पर्सनालिटी फ्रॉम सिंगापुर हु हैज एक्सपर्टीज इन क्वालिटी, एनवायरमेंट, health and safety, internal auditing procedure and supports. Let us welcome Dr. B. Ramanathan from Singapore. Welcome, Dr. Ramanathan.
Thank you, Abba. Thank you for all watching this particular session. I'm very happy to be with you today with the Spotlight with Abba.
Thank you. So friends, before we proceed, let me give a brief introduction of Dr. B. Ramanathan. Dr. B. Ramanathan is the founder and managing director of ACE International Private Limited, that is ACE, Singapore. He has 20 years of experiences both in research and development and learning and development sectors. His research experiences comprises with biomedical science and clinical research areas in few renowned institutions, including National University of Singapore and Sing Health Singapore, Tai Pei Veterans General Hospital, National Yang Ming University, Taiwan, Academia Sinica, Taiwan, Chang Gung University, Taiwan, India Institute of Science, India, Bharti Dasan University, India. During his career, he published book chapters and peer-reviewed articles, as well as provided lead talks in seminars, workshops, and conferences. Further, he has acted as mentors for research projects and received several awards to his academic and research credits. Friends, this is just a glimpse of what Dr. B. Ramanathan is indulged into.
Thank you for your nice introduction about me. It gave everything, so I no need to talk again, I think. It's okay. Thank you so much.
So you have been working in R&D since last 20 years. What research methodologies you have developed?
Yeah, my PhD pertinent with laboratory animals, because of my passion to learn something, the immunology or immunotechnics. As of now, the pandemic is revolved with the technique because they need a vaccine to protect the whole human beings. So it was the fascination for everyone to want to know certain techniques when they are entering into the PhD program. Without techniques or technology or equipments, it is very difficult to finish a task on research and innovation. So we were coming out from the masters, we have to push ourselves and we need to learn certain techniques to evolve for our PhD program. And we have to select the concept which are going to make some kind of answers for the unrevealed questions or any expectations from our research. So vaccine research I was doing with the animal model, a small animal model like mice. It was an efficacy study to prove for a vaccine candidate, especially in contraceptive vaccine development. I learned my techniques from India Institute of Medical Science, New Delhi, and the National Institute of Immunology associated with Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi, and IIS Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, as well as several other institutions like Anna University Biotechnology and so on. Because we need to learn from some collaborative researchers as well as other established research centers in national level. India has a prolonged history even from the British colony period onwards, because we have very well established research centers all over the India. So it was the fascination for me to learn and explore. Then after my PhD, I got the opportunity in Indian Institute of Science as a research associate in Center for Molecular Reproduction and Developmental Genetics. And then after that, I got the opportunity in overseas, especially from Taiwan. So I thought my overseas trip will make me to learn more and excel further. So I chose the opportunity to move out from India in year 2003. That time it was the pandemic situation of SARS. Still, I remember now we are in the COVID-19. So it was the challenge for me to enter into a new country and started my career. That time it was the condition for me to learn the in vitro cell culture techniques, because my work very well matched with the in vitro cell culture for genotoxicology mechanisms to unveil with certain answers for the physicians who are willing to learn from laboratory studies, especially for the cancer patients, toxicological environment, which are going to make the carcinogenic induction in the human beings, as well as the genetic factors. There are DNA damage and repair mechanisms very well addressed for the carcinogenic effect, which are formed in the human human beings. So we have done several works and we published a few papers, toxicological research as well as cancer research, and few more journals. I have presented some papers in international conference. So that was the level I started to learn myself in the in vitro cell culture. So now I can handle both in vivo and in vitro. Then later period, I moved to National University of Singapore, Faculty of Medicine, Department of Biochemistry, where we were working together for translational medicine. What is translational medicine? Bench to bed, bed to bench. Because we have certain questions from the clinical side, the patients who wanted to treat well, or the therapy they want to make well. So they need to study some kind of mechanisms or any kind of features or factors which are affecting the health status. So we can do certain studies in vitro or in vivo in laboratory. Then later that concepts can be transferred to the clinical side to address the questions, the answers, relevant answers. So that way we have explored, and it was the fascinating thing again, the translational medicine booming up everywhere, all over the world. So that was the scenario. I developed certain techniques like Komath assay. Komath assay was a DNA damage and repair capacity we can able to do in the laboratory. We have done several factors to tune up how do we able to sensitize, like a radio sensitivity for the cancer tissue. We can able to detect through this Komath assay how much the radiations you have to give for the tissue. Because sometimes the lethal effect will damage the normal tissue surrounding with the cancer tissue. So that way we have done wonderful things, explore the possibility of using the laboratory techniques. How do we able to address well for the patients to recover better from their health improvements?
Great, that's really commendable. What is one thing which you like and would like to share about your experience while writing your book?
The things, because when I was starting my career in institution wise higher learning institute, mostly we were very much fascinating towards with the students who wanted to aspirate well, and they wanted to address well for the society, where they can able to explore the possibility of a new workforce environment. So we are in a hand, the challenges what we have, we need to connect them very well to the ground reality of the scenario in the society, especially not only with the working environment, also connect to the public environment. So we are the institute, industry, and the society. It is comprising the whole world. So we cannot able to isolate each other. So as an institutional members, they are in the boundary as well as duty conscious. How do they develop the higher learning environment, higher education quality? Because it is going to apply towards with the industry as well as to transform to the social applications or societal expectations. So the government is always willing to support in this scenario, because they wanted to take care of the whole nation in order to develop the educational institutions to move for the futuristic visions or futuristic tasks to be manageable by the new workforce. So everywhere the crises are very big, And now the government is also having a lot of problem for investing in higher learning institutions, especially the R&D projects and all. So the industry partners are coming on together with the government to provide certain kind of funding sources to conduct together for the industrial problems to be solved with the institutional people. So this is the kind of area like institutional industry partnerships. So we are looking for the opportunity in this area because already I developed certain kind of ways for my R&D environment where I can able to support for the industrial people if they have any problems. So the institutional people, the professor, the students, or the incubation center or incubation innovation, they can able to help them. They can able to work on the problems and they can solve it because the industries are very busy. They are very busy to produce the products or service to the needy things for the customer-centric values. So they cannot able to do all these things in the backlog center. The same time, the institutions also, they are having the boundary to finish the curricular learning, the portions to cover, they have to conduct the exams, they have to qualify the students to pushing them out from the institution. So both the places they were having this, so we are the middle people. So we can able to analyze and we can able to buffer it, where we can able to do the better things for the institution-wise, industry-wise, and we can make it possible for the social applications.
Wonderful. That's really wonderful work you are doing, Dr. Ramanathan. I just want to know that you are National Vice President, Guild of International Speakers and Trainers, Singapore, what advice you would like to give for today's speakers and trainers?
Yeah, thank you so much. It was a recent update. I now become president of Guild of International Speakers and Trainers. It was started nearly 2018. And when we have the thought for the social organizations to register in Singapore, because we need to value the people who have the capability or they can able to build up the capacity for the people. The two ways, one is the public speaking capacity and another one is the training, the customized training or structured training or any kind of assigned training atmosphere for the organization as well as the government portfolio. Because now the lifelong learning, the agility of learning or continuous learning kind of situations, everywhere they need to go with different kind of trainings or different kind of atmospheres to learn continuously to progress for their goal sets. Because time to time, the updates are coming. When we learn something 10 years back, 20 years back, now the whole concept might be changed. So we need to develop some new updates and we have to work out with the new updates for proliferation for our futuristic mission. So that was the condition. So in Singapore, the Toastmaster clubs and other public speaking forums are doing very great things. Singapore is multiracial community. So it is very competitive environment. So the persons who are coming to Singapore, they need to incubate and they have to develop not only for the organization requirement, as well as they have to speak to the clients or other collaborators or joint venturing groups or clients everywhere. So they need to develop their public speaking ability, commanding sense, as well as communication skills or any kind of decision making and that. So it is the grooming skills. So they need to incubate and develop. The another way, Singapore Workforce Development Authority under the Ministry of Manpower, they developed the workforce skill qualification, WSQ. So as I already mentioned, they wanted to bring the world talents to come and work in Singapore. At the same time, they want to build up the nation very competitive because the investors are looking for the ground value where they can able to pump in the money and get back the return. So Singapore is transforming towards the smart nation environment. They must need to attract world talents to come and work and engage their commitment to bring out something for the Singapore sake. So it is the betterment for the local people who are living here and the overseas community who wanted to come and take over from Singapore atmosphere. So both the public speaking and the training atmospheres are very well required. So the Guild of International Speakers and Trainers, a society, non-profit organization, we want to develop certain kind of categories along with the education, like Ministry of Education or any government bodies who wanted to aspirate well and provide the support for the society, as well as CSR, the corporate social responsibilities. So we are working together with these communities. How do we able to give better and make better for the futuristic society? So this is the aspiration we have, and we are working good, and we are developing good. Now we are looking to move on to the overseas partnership, associationship, or collaborations. So it is an opportunity for everyone all around the world.
So is there any age limit to come into this talent, what you have talked about? So is there any particular age limit?
Especially from students, we have separate category, primary, upper primary, like third standard onwards, and the secondary students, as well as junior college or polytechnic level, or degree or higher learning like masters or PhD holders like that. So the student category is this boundary. Our professionals, we want to attract the PMET category, professional, managerial, executives, and technical cadre people. Because Singapore workforce entirely depend on these four categories, majority manner. And SME sectors are the vital support of Singapore. They are the heartbeat of Singapore economy. So the SME sectors entirely depend on the workforces who are doing the greatness for the organization to lift up well or upscale level well. Then only they can able to showcase their competencies to work with the customers' need. So that is the way Singapore is a very small country, but they are making very fabulous growth aspects for this country to lead in all over the world. So they are the Asiatic hub center, the place for many overseas companies to come and launch their Asiatic headquarters in Singapore. And the government is also supporting a lot for leveraging the compliance regulations, lawfully control the environment. So these are all, I'm protecting the fintech kind of atmospheres. In many ways, their safe, secure, hygienic practices attracted the whole world to come and launch something in Singapore atmosphere.
That's really yes. Great. So what are the services you are offering for the professionals and corporates?
Courses are the vital source of Singapore. Many companies, they wanted to ensure the organizational standards. So the government also regulated. There are certain training and development areas as mandatory level. So anyhow, wherever, however, whatever they are coming to Singapore, they need to take over this kind of training. It is the must one, like F&B hygienic practices, workplace safety and health practices, occupational hygiene practices, or emergency response team or first aider, all these things are mandatory. The company must need to have the trained people or any managing hazardous substance like that. It is coming under with occupational hygiene. So in order to protect the country safe and secure and hygienic status to maintain, they wanted to ensure these kind of trainings. It is nearly 34 industrial frameworks are there, IT, tourism, security, cleaning services, traveling, transportation, logistics, so many areas, because they ensure all these categories are meeting the compliance regulations and the roles and responses. If they are not going to meet, what would be the consequence they have to face? So that way the workforces are retained in their mind, and they have to contribute well for the ecosystem of Singapore. This is the category. And where we can able to pump in, because we are entirely depending with the emerging countries, because we cannot say all over the world the smart nation anymore. But there are areas they need to develop. And the emerging countries, the biggest challenges are they can't able to focus because of the lacking of infrastructure, lacking of the knowledge, lacking of the collaborative capacity. So smart nation environment need to go and find the gap where they can able to build up the support. And the same way, the emerging country people can able to come and visit Singapore. What are the areas they need to give attention and improve? especially already I told the futuristic courses are tailor-made from the institutions. So the faculties, the students through exchange programs or foreign visit like internship programs or student exchange or whatever the manner, they can be able to come and look at this kind of atmosphere. They can visit institutions, they can visit industries, they can see the environment of Singapore, how do they able to manage. So then only it is giving some kind of idea for them, and they can go back and implement in their place by the way of joint venture with the Singapore companies or Singapore supporters or expertise people. So these are all the way we can able to explore the new possibilities. Now the pandemic situation of COVID-19 affected all over the world because we cannot physically move, but still we have luckily this online platform. So we can able to provide the support through online. Earlier, we need to invite your overseas expert and they can come over and provide the seminars, attending the conferences like that. But now it is very easy, virtual conference, online webinars, or online virtual conferences like that we can able to arrange. So we can able to support whatever the way, because it is not only for the money sake, but it is duty for as a human being to address the value our fellow human to uplift their life in a better way.
That's really great, and I'm damn sure that with your trainings and your guidance, as you have now taken the charge, I think you will be able to develop that focus and make them attentive in their goal achievement and goal setting. In fact, I say so. Can you throw now more light on health and safety aspects?
Especially, I already told Singapore has created safe, secure, and hygienic practices, but now everything was thrown out in front of the virus because we could not able to address the need. How do we? But we have managed somehow by wearing the mask, making ourselves the hygienic practices, wash your hand, and it's the safety distances you have to maintain. So Singapore was listed in January or early this year, the 2020. Next to China, because after the Chinese New Year, many people returned back from China and it was spreading in like a little bit very worryful manner. Then the government has implemented, they started to practice certain ways to control the spreading and all. But even though the foreign visitors, they are bringing the virus to spread in the community, and it was transformed to the workforces. Because the workers also moved here and there, they return back to their home country and they again come back to the country to work. And that way, and then the people are moving here and there. So then only the whole world stopped the travel and other ways to spread. So they don't want to make more risks. Because still now they can't able to assure whether the treatment they have or they can able to stop the virus to spread further. As a biologist, I can able to understand because the virus is very tiny organism and it is getting mutated very virulently, very strongly. So we can't say this is the unique virus everywhere the same. If we raise any therapies or any methods, vaccines, it may work for certain virulent form, but not for other virulent form. So that's why they are getting confused and they are waiting. So how do they able to manage this virus to treat it in a better way? The spreading also, we can't say now, you could see the children are not affected very much. I don't know what is the truth. The death case or infectious case, because they are using bare hand. They are not very hygienic, what we adult people are reflecting. They are touching, they are making the things to touch on the face, the openings. So it is a condition for them, but I don't know, maybe the virus is very merciful to not to affect too much of children, but it is having certain mechanisms. We don't know many things actually, but their early stage may not take well for the virus to be a host and a transform. I don't know, but it is the mechanism related to the age factors. But the senior people like more than 50 years old or 60 years old, they are very susceptible because the system, due to the aging things, or they are having any chronic conditions of illness, and they are taking any other medicines which may modify their immune response, immunomodulatory mechanisms. So that way the antibody secretions may delay, we don't know. And other side, the people are not having disciplinary mechanisms. They are doing smoking and they are drinking alcohol, their practices in other ways. So that will also change their immunomodulatory mechanisms. Immune responses are not good enough. Those kind of people also affected a lot because they can't recover as quick as possible like other people. So still we could not able to.
It may be possible because of the weak immunity system. As we grow into adult, our food habits, they become very much on junk food, and we start eating less hygienic food and more junk food kind of thing. And because of that intake, we continuously our immunity gets degraded if we don't maintain.
You need to go and investigate with the hygienic practices, how it would be maintained in the tribal populations.
Yeah.
They don't have a refrigerator, they don't have packet system, they don't have hygienic living style in the forest. Mm-hmm. But it is a $1 million question. I can say lifestyle or the practices, how do we, because we learn to evolve like this, the modern life. We wear the clothes, or we manage something, the climatic factors. Our food habits also changed a lot. The traditional food habits, because traditional food habits, they never store for a long time. But now you prepare anything from Monday, you can keep it in the refrigerator for Sunday. Because it is the way that people are practicing and they are changing their food behaviors and all. We can't able to make. But we need to do a lot of studies in the lifestyles. Because the lifestyles are not very unique for everyone, because somebody depend on rice, somebody in north and south also in India, wheat products, or some white flows like the noodles and all they prepare in Chinese tech. So we can't say which food is comfortable, which food is giving you the strong support, because people are who are living in any condition, like climatic conditions like desert or snow falling areas, or plains, or the high altitudes. We can't say who is living better and stronger and they are going away with the natural death. There is no fixed philosophy or hypothesis. They are living, the body system is very personal. I can say usually physical, physiological, psychological, ethical, emotional, environmental, economic. These are all the orchestra to play the music for your life.
Absolutely.
So any keys will down, the orchestra will not give the smooth music.
Yes.
So we can't say, we need to study a lot. I can say, we need to study a lot from the nature and environment, and we have to fix certain concepts. This is the way the aging factor can be controlled. This is the way the normal life can lead for until their death. And there are minimal requirements like avoidable health risks, especially the occupational things, especially the workplace safe, unsafe conditions, and the way the onset of aging factors, which are accumulating a lot. If you ignore certain things, it will make the risk and it will make the condition for the chronic diseases. And you have to bound to the treatment, therapy. Every day, whether they are eating or not, they have to take the pills or any additional therapy supports. So we can able to predict, and we have to give some better knowledge transfer to the community. How to adapt all these factors considerable, and especially the holistic way or integrated way, we can't able to omit, because in India, we have the traditional therapy methods like Siddha, Ayurvedic, Yunani, many ways, homeopathy and all. So we have everything, but now towards with the Western medicine, allopathy and all, is getting more stronger and it is becoming very great manner. But we need to work for the holistic or integrated methods, which are going to support a lot for the people who want to get good health and wellness practices. I am also conducting several health and wellness talks, associating with the different people. My personal vision as well as the expectation is, how do we able to generate the knowledge for the people who want to secure their life very well. Especially, I can say the three factors which are able to make you whether you are being normal life or not. One is your thirst, another one is your hungry, the next one is your sleep. If you keep these three normal, you feel thirst to drink and quench your thirst, or if you feel hungry to energize yourself, eat something and make yourself complete rest. Because we did not know much about that. The rest is curing many things. The detoxifying mechanisms are working when you are taking rest. So many people, they ignore. Maybe they study well, but they forget well also.
Absolutely right, Dr. Ramanathan, that these three pillars, that is thirst, hunger, and sleep. So these are the three pillars on which our body actually functions in a proper way. If you are taking care of these pillars, our body will come into a strong building. And if we are not taking care of these pillars, then definitely we are prone more to the diseases and everything. We'll become home of diseases then soon. So I hope that people are aware of these system, how to take care of these system. And as speakers like you are there, trainers like you are there, so I'm 100% sure that awareness will be soon created among your community. And when you come to India, definitely we expect that thing will come with you to us also. No doubt, nowadays it's a virtual world, so we can connect on this way also. But it affects more when you talk face to face.
True, because the physical exposure and experience are different, which may not get compensated by the actual thing, but we can manage because lacking of the time period, maybe we can bridge the gap through these ritual contacts and communications.
So Dr. Ram, with this, we come to end of our program. I know there are a lot many things we need to discuss because this topic is such that it can be discussed up to a great length. But as we know that the program has a limitation of time. So at the end, I just want to ask you that with this immense knowledge at your command, what one advice you wish to give to our audience?
It's a good question also because it is the vision and mission of ACE International Andhra Division. As a community excellence, it is not only for the individual, for the organization, or for the global community. So everyone must think about the excellence status. How are they able to engage their life? I can simply say that you can follow the template. Template is very simple for you to cope up well. T for technical, E for execution, M for managerial, P for professional, L for leadership, A for authenticity or authority, T for talents or some kind of thinkers, and E for excellence. So this is the step-by-step process. And if you acquire all this capacity, you can make yourself an excellent personality and you can contribute well for the global people as well as community very well. And another one important thing, earlier, the recruitment process was different. They look for educated, experienced people. But now, as a company like us and any other people, they are very much looking for the talents. The talents mean who are having the task completing competency skills. So now everywhere the problems are more and more. So the problem solving capacity is only available with the talents. Who can able to think and who can able to develop the system which are going to eradicate the problems. And that is the solution required for everywhere. So we need to improve our capacity category or understanding of the current knowledge or getting the updates for the futuristic vision. Everywhere the nations also now adopting with the modernist thinking like the Industry 4.0, automation, machine learning, digital transformational solutions. And recently, I have published a book, e-book, the disruptive challenges in emerging countries. Nearly 20 chapters are available, addressing various kind of answers for the people who want to uplift their life. If anybody requires that, you can approach me. I can send it free. No problem. There is no cost for it. That way, I am looking for the opportunity with collaborative partners. Together, we can work for the betterment for the people as well as the community to upscale or lift up their life into the next level. So the current scenario, making the new normal, but we have to accelerate our capacity as well as bringing our abilities together, and we can make the challenge as well as the conditions to fit for us, live for us better in the world.
Absolutely. And I'm 100% sure the concept of template you have given over here, my audience, my viewers, they are going to follow it. And maybe if they can understand it in a bit, I think they will get its nice result. So that is what I expect from my viewers, to follow the guidelines, the success tip given by Dr. Ramanathan. Also, sir, I just want to ask that if a person, just last one tip, if they have to survive best, not the three pillars you've already told, just last 1 minute, 1 minute I want to take, because this question has come, you know, continuously keeping in my mind. So what is that one best tip you will give to have a proper control on the health?
Proper control on the health, because as earlier I pointed out, everybody is unique. Even the identical twins also are unique. They may born together, but they may not die together. Yeah. You could see the scenario, because they are born together in the same time. Maybe one child comes first, another child comes next. But their lifestyle, their thinking, their capacity, their ideological things may not be the same, even the identical things. So we could not able to identify what is the correct scenario, correct platform we can able to live. But as far as we can understand the ecosystem, as earlier I pointed out, physical, physiological, psychological, ethical, emotional, environmental, economical, or you can expand in any other way. So the reality is the perceptions. Wherever you are, whatever you are, however you are, you have to make your mind as well as concept, make the fulfillment of your desires. If you are having more, or you are making more undesirable kind of way to explore, it forms certain kind of stress. So you have to identify your stress factors, avoid the stress, manage with the surrounding in the reality manner. You have to accept and compromise for the betterment of living together with the people in your family or in your social environment or with the global perspective. Because as of this pandemic, I can make you to think about the theory revealed by Darwin, the natural selections, survival of the fittest, struggle for existence, use and disuse theory. This was developed and revealed by Charles Darwin for many organisms which are capable of living better in the community as well as ecosystem. So now the pandemic situation also making the human being to take over, struggle for existence, survival of the fittest, use and disuse theory. Applicable for our well-being as well as health perspectives. So be safe and maintain the safe distance practices very well, and save yourself and save others.
Absolutely. A nice, short and sweet message, but yet a very strong message you have given. So Dr. Ramanathan, it was all complete a power-packed session, which has, I am damn sure, inspired my lot of viewers, and they will definitely follow what success mantras you have shared with us today. And with this, I take leave from our spotlight, our program Spotlight with Abha. and thank you for being here, for giving your valuable time to me and my viewers.
Thank you so much. I am very glad to join with you today with the Spotlight with Abba. I may think the viewers also getting benefit out of our both of our conversation, your question and my answers. So we are looking for the betterment for the community as well as people. We can work together and feel free to reach me as per the contact given by them. We are happy to serve you and support you better. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.
Yes, but before we leave, let me ask my viewers to download Radio Brainrhyme application so that they can listen to the broadcast of this program on Radio Brainrhyme, which has been heard in more than 22 countries. And also, you have to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Abha Jadhav, to view the other episodes of Spotlight with Abha. With that, we come to the end of the program, but we'll come again and inspire you with the story of one more successful personality. Till then, bye-bye, namaskar.